There are loads of free infographic creation tools out there where you simply plug in your data and they churn out some sort of visualization. If you need to create an infographic quickly and your KPI is simply deliver infographic and no one cares about the quality, then these tools are great. However, if your infographic is part of a marketing strategy that is measured on prospect engagement and lead gen, then a plug-and-play infographic tool isn't going to cut it. In my opinion, nothing worth doing is that easy. So, if you're tasked with creating a quality infographic that people are drawn to and that actually supports your marketing objectives, then here are 8 steps to follow. Don't do anything in marketing without an objective. At Topline, we believe in content with a purpose, which means every piece of content is produced with a clear objective in mind. Is that purpose to drive visits to your website, to generate followed links that support your SEO strategy, to make a story more appealing to journalists as part of your PR efforts, or maybe you're doing the infographic to simplify a complex concept that your sales team finds they have to explain repeatedly. Whatever it is, your purpose should guide you throughout the creation phase. Once you have your purpose, think about how you're going to distribute the infographic, as the distribution strategy will definitely inform the content and the design. Start by looking at all the data sources available to you. Does your company have its own data? What publicly available data can you use? How has the data been used before? Will you need to commission research? How might the data be of interest to the target audience? Why would they care about it? What benefit does it bring them? Do you need to use all the data? Interrogate your data until you genuinely understand it. Hold a brainstorm with your team, discuss the data in detail, and make sure you've got your head around it fully. This isn't an infographic issue, it's a wider marketing issue. Your marketing strategy should be built around an understanding of what your target customer wants. And of course, this needs to be tied back to your business objectives, which is a bit of a tricky task. Once you've chosen your wider subject and you know your potential sources of data, refine your hook to make sure you're creating an infographic that's going to appeal to the market. We do this by speaking to people in the target audience and getting their opinions or feedback. Or we look on tools like BuzzSumo and Google Trends to see what's trending. What are the most shared topics on a subject? We also use keyword research tools to identify what people are searching for around the subject. Then we tie this back to our purpose. How do you match the data you have with what the audience wants and still achieve your purpose? It's not an easy task, but it's worth doing thoroughly if you want your infographic to be a success. An infographic isn't simply a place to vomit out all the data you have. You need to establish what the story is that your data tells and what the point is that you're trying to make with that story. A list of facts and stats isn't interesting. You need to have a story or a purpose behind it. Take something from the real world that can be used to visualize the data you have and create a visual metaphor. That way, people will instantly recognize, understand, and remember it. For example, if your data is about school results, make it a report card or a blackboard. If your data is about gambling, use a pack of cards or a roulette wheel or a slot machine. The opportunities are endless and you can carry the metaphor throughout the infographic. I found some examples that do this quite well. The periodic table of SEO success factors by Search Engine Land and The Race to Economic Growth by Grant Thornton. It's absolutely not your designer's job to come up with the concept and understand how to visualize your data. You need to work with the designer to develop a brief that will result in the most creative output. I recommend sitting down with your designer and explaining to him or her what you're trying to achieve with the infographic. Then you can work on metaphors together and hone and organize the content you need to display. Infographic templates are boring. I recommend working with a creative designer who understands how to use design to communicate. The designer won't just summarize your data on a JPEG and call it an infographic. She'll use visuals instead of words, graphs or icons instead of numbers. She knows that someone should be able to skim through the image and get the gist without actually having to read it in detail. Once your infographic is ready, it's time to start promoting it. This should be relatively easy, as you would have considered distribution right at the start. Finally, don't make these infographic mistakes, making it too complicated. Infographics are about simplifying complex data into easily digestible formats. So if the reader has to really think to be able to understand it, then they're going to most likely abandon it. Making it too generic. Infographics about broad subjects aren't going to be of interest to your target audience, and even if they are, you'll already have loads of competition. Giving the raw data to a designer and asking them to turn it into an infographic. That's not fair. The designer needs you to interpret the data and brief them on what's important. Overstretching the metaphor. Metaphors are great, but they only work so far. Your data cannot perfectly be explained as a recipe or a map, so keep the metaphors high level. Now you know how to make a proper infographic. Good luck, and thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like it, share it, and most importantly, subscribe to 4 Minute Tech.